The U.S. Navy has released footage of an absolutely massive joint show of force in the Philippine Sea that included two carrier strike groups, two amphibious ready groups, and a helicopter destroyer from the Japanese Maritime Self-Defense Force, JMSDF. In the days following this exercise, China sent dozens of aircraft into Taiwan's Air Defense Identification Zone, or ADIZ, which included a rare appearance of the Shenyang J-16D Electronic Warfare, EW, aircraft in its first known Taiwanese ADIZ incursion. Today, the Navy directed both carrier groups into the South China Sea, the northeastern corner of which is inside Taiwan's ADIZ. In a release published today, the U.S. Navy says Carrier Strike Group, CSG, one led by USS Carl Vinson, and CSG-3 led by USS Abraham Lincoln have now begun dual carrier operations. Rear Admiral J.T. Anderson, commander of CSG-3, says that the operation is intended to improve our combat credible capability, reassure our allies and partners, and demonstrate our resolve as a Navy to ensure regional stability and counter malign influence. Rear Admiral Dan Martin, commander of CSG-1, says the dual carrier operation highlights the U.S. Navy's ability to deliver overwhelming maritime force, when called upon, to support a free and open Indo-Pacific region and shows the service's commitment to deterring those who challenge the shared vision of a free and open Indo-Pacific now and into the long-term future. Nothing reaffirms our commitment to a free and open Indo-Pacific like, two, carrier strike groups, two, amphibious ready groups sailing alongside our close friends from the Japan Maritime Self-Defense Force, said Vice Admiral Carl Thomas, Commander, U.S. 7th Fleet. According to the Navy, CSG-1 currently includes aircraft carrier USS Carl Vinson, CVN-70, with embarked carrier air wing, CVW-2, Ticonderoga-class guided missile cruiser USS Lake Champlain, CG-57, Arleigh Burke-class guided missile destroyers USS Stockdale, DDG-106, and USS Chaffee, DDG-90, replenishment ship USNS Yukon, TAO-202, and dry cargo and ammunition ship USNS Washington Chambers, TAKE-11. CSG-3 includes USS Abraham Lincoln, CVN-72, with embarked carrier air wing, CVW-9, Ticonderoga-class USS Mobile Bay, CG-53, and Arleigh Burke-class destroyers USS Fitzgerald, DDG-62, USS Gridley, DDG-101, USS Sampson, DDG-102, and USS Spruance, DDG-111. USS Sampson has been detached to Tonga to assist in relief efforts following the volcanic eruption and tsunami earlier this month. Submarines are known to accompany carrier strike groups and amphibious ready groups, although the Department of Defense does not typically publicize their presence. The U.S. Navy's dual carrier operations in the South China Sea come shortly after Taiwan reported two more large Chinese incursions into its ADIZ this week. The Chinese sent a total of 39 aircraft through the southwestern corner of Taiwan's Air Defense Identification Zone, including two Y-9G electronic warfare aircraft, 10 Chengdu J-10 multi-role fighters, 24 Tandem Seek J-16 fighters, a pair of Shaanxi Y-8 Elant aircraft, and a CNH-6 bomber. Thirteen Chinese aircraft entered Taiwan's Air Defense Identification Zone once again, this time including two J-16D electronic attack/electronic warfare aircraft. This is the first time these new aircraft have appeared during one of these incursions, a potential sign that more of these new J-16 variants are operational and ready to be deployed. The J-16D reportedly made its first flight in December 2015 and features a radome design distinctly different from the base J-16 that points to the EW aircraft having an Advanced Active Electronically Scanned Array, AESA, radar. The exact capabilities of the J-16D, which is often compared to the U.S. Navy's EA-18G Growler, are unknown, though the aircraft has been seen at airshows carrying at least three different electronic warfare pods. The addition of aerial electronic warfare support would factor heavily into any potential Chinese military intervention across the Taiwan Strait given the island's significant air defense capabilities. The new appearance of the J-16D reflects comments made by U.S. Air Force leadership in recent years that the United States is out of time in terms of the PLA catching up to the modern capabilities of the U.S. military, at least in some respects. Those Chinese flights came on the heels of previous U.S. Navy joint exercises conducted with the Japan Maritime Self-Defense Force, which took place last week in the Philippine Sea. That exercise brought together the largest operational gathering of naval F-35s to date, with 10 F-35CS from Strike Fighter Squadron, VFA 147, 10 Marine Corps F-35CS flying on behalf of Marine Fighter Attack Squadron, VMFA 314, and 6 Marine Corps F-35BS aboard USS America, CVA/CV-66. CSG-1 and CSG-3 were joined in those exercises by the Japanese vessel JS Hyuga. DDH-181, a helicopter-equipped destroyer with the ability to fire anti-submarine and anti-aircraft missiles from its vertical launch system, and Japanese guided missile destroyer JS Myoko, DDG-175. The inclusion of Japanese naval forces in these exercises shows the U.S. ally is at least trying to take a more proactive role in the maritime domain when it comes to China.